We've cut taxes for the typical middle-class family by $3,600.
Shortly after his announcement on tax cuts for the middle class, we catch up with the president to ask him about the political implications of the move.
And I would imagine that this is going to inflame the rhetoric that this administration is engaging in class warfare.
You know, it really shouldn't. I mean, here's what's at stake. We've got the Bush tax cuts are set to expire at the end of this year. And I feel very strongly that the middle class tax cuts, which would affect 98% of Americans, should be extended further. Now is not the time for a tax increase on the middle class. The Republicans say they agree with that. Well, what we should do is work on what we agree on.
And as we head to November, the blueprint on health care appears to be set, except for the choices that individual states can now make on key parts of it.
The state of New Hampshire has sent back the money. The federal government has given it to set up the insurance exchanges. There's a strong possibility that the state will opt out of the Medicaid expansion for fear that after the federal government gets done picking up the tab, the state will go bankrupt. Why are they wrong?
Well, they're wrong, first of all, because the federal government picks up the tab for a long time. Second of all, when it comes to the exchanges, all we're talking about is putting together a pool where people who don't have health insurance can get the same kind of bargain that those of us who work with big companies do, get discounts on their rates, which will benefit a lot of folks in New Hampshire.
Back here live in Washington now, and while the president certainly can't escape the fact that he's locked in a tight race with Mitt Romney, he did have to talk about it today. Coming up at 6 o'clock, we'll have more on our one-on-one. Mitt Romney does come up. We talk about his financial records a little bit. We also find out whether Vice President Joe Biden is a lock for the president to be his running mate for a second time. Again, that's new at 6 o'clock. Now reporting live in Washington at the White House, I'm Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.
Now, Josh, before we let you go, we heard that you also asked the president about his thoughts on New Hampshire's role in the election process. What did he have to say about that?
Well, I can tell you, Tom, he didn't miss that opportunity. He hit that one out of the park, saying that New Hampshire is the most important state when it comes to the presidential selection process, not only because of the primary, but also because of the pivotal role that it could play come November. And he also said something that most of us in New Hampshire already know, that we certainly do take our politics very seriously. Tom?